Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and welcome to the Conference Championship here in the Big West Tournament in the Long Beach State Dynasty. How about this? In Season 1, Long Beach has already reached this game. How about that? And with an 18-13 record in the regular season. Now we're going up against UC Irvine, who is really, really good at scoring the basketball. But last time we played them, we actually beat them. In a sim, we lost to them by over 20. I believe it was actually a 30-point loss, to be honest. But they have size, and it's unreal size. I have no idea how they built their team like this. But literally everybody's like 6'8 and above, and they are just monstrous. You know, my strategy in game number one was really to use our smaller guys to their advantage and kind of use our quickness. That's what we're going to do here in the conference championship. So let's get this game underway. Here is UC Irvine. They win the tip, and we do get a miss early on and push it up the court now. Let's see if we can get the first bucket of the game. Here's Takashi in the post. I'm going to work it inside to him, and he gets a little baby hook to go. And we get the first points of the game on the board here. Is Takashi gets us going of all people. So here's a post move this time, and that is Aiden Johnson, who is a junior. Remember, these teams are filled with you guys. As now we come off of a miss, and look at this. Wide open layup for Storm, and he does hit it. I thought he was going to miss that one. An early 4-2 lead here for Long Beach. So working it around this time off of the corner, and that is JD Joyner with the three, and he makes it a 3-point lead early on in the first half. So off of a rebound, pushing it up the court. Nobody stops Caesar, and he just pulls up for three. That's nothing but nets. And how about Caesar, man? That guy can shoot the basketball. Remember, he is a senior as well, so you want to end his career off right. So calling for the pick and roll this time. Joyner at the top passes it back out to Caesar again for three, and he nails it. 2-for-2 from three for Caesar. It's a 13-4 early lead here. As you can just see, we're shooting the ball early on, and it's going in. An early 10-point lead already. We are 5-of-6 to start this game. But here is Aiden Johnson this time handling the ball at the top. Remember, these guys are all like 6'8" and above. So that is like a center handling the ball right there. So here's an open three. This time it's Timmy Mitch. And he did do pretty well versus us in the first matchup. And with those two buckets, I mean, they're right back in this game. So here is Mitch this time, a fadeaway two. Oh, my goodness. How did he hit that shot? Now it's just a 3-point game. But here is Storm on the offensive end, finally breaking that little bit of a run by UC Irvine. And gets the inside layup. It's now it's a 3-point game. Storm, a little pick and roll, and that is going to be passed inside. And I believe that was Buster Howard inside. And now that makes it a 5-point lead. JD Joyner, mid-range, and it's bouncing around, and that goes in, extending this lead back to 7. So the bench comes in this time. Here's Joseph Spratley off the bench. We're working it back around to him. Open three, and he does nail it. Spratley has showed that he can shoot the ball pretty well, especially when he's open. But obviously his contestant threes do need to get better, as he is just a freshman. He's got 4 years of this. So here's a drive inside, and Buster Howard gets called for the foul that time. And that puts on the line Xavier Norris, who is their starting center, averaging 10-6. The first free throw up. And it is good, and it will be about an 8-point lead if he makes this one at 7, and they do trim it down here with 6 minutes left here in the first half. So now a 5-point lead, missed shot this time by UC Irvine. Wendell Caesar pushing it up the court, passing around, and that's an open shot from Storm. It's good. 8-point lead here for Long Beach, shooting 73% in the first half. So looking for the pick and roll this time. Here is Storm trying to get around a defender. But remember, everybody's taller than him and bigger, but a fadeaway three. A 9-point lead here for Long Beach. We are hitting everything so far. Working it around once again. Storm, three, bang. How about that? 18 points in the first half. 7-of-9 from the field. How about this defense too? Timmy Mitch, that's a miss. We hold for the last shot, 10 seconds left. Let's see if we can get a good shot here. As Caesar's open, deep three, it is good! The shooting in the first half by Long Beach has been the difference. They heave it up at halftime, and it's no good. 11-point lead here for Long Beach. We are 20 minutes away, really 16 minutes because that's what we play it on, but away from our first conference championship and our first NCAA tournament bid. Remember, the winner goes to the tournament. It's a 38-27 game here in the first half. What a game. So now we move on to the second half, and how about this shooting? 75% from the field, 67 from three. I mean, that is just incredible. No way we're probably going to keep this up, but if we do, I mean, that is just probably the greatest game we've played so far in this series. So here is Irvine back on offense to start out this first possession in a jump shot that time, and that is Vontaze Bell, who led the conference. At least he was second in the conference in scoring. And now we get a steal here in transition. Open three. Storm, good. 41-29. Storm has 21 in this game. And now it seems like this lead could keep growing. Now with a 14-point lead. Working it around. Timmy Mitch this time handling the ball. Nice pick. Oh, my goodness. And he dunks it. Nobody stops the ball. And he does get in for the easy dunk. And that brings it to a 12-point lead. But on the next possession, passing it right up, not wasting any time chucking up these threes. It's a 15-point lead here for Long Beach. We have the lead, and we are not looking back. Looking for the pick and roll this time. Here's Storm from distance, and that is good. 16-point lead now, the largest lead of the game. Storm can't be stopped. Another open three. Actually, that's a hand in his face, and he hits it. I think they counted that one as a two. It's now an 18-point lead. 51-33. Here is Irvine. This time driving the lane is Cameron Pimentel, and he brings it back down to 16. But this is a huge lead for Long Beach. Getting a little pick here from Bamaye, passing it to the corner. It's Joseph Spratley. How about him getting going? And honestly, I did not see this coming. He has been playing so well lately. He's been shooting the ball well also. So here is Caesar back into the game. And he just pulls up. Why not? Let it fly. And how about this? The three-point shooting in this game has just been unstoppable. And it has been very, very fun to watch, to be honest. I mean, this is just incredible. Another three. Spratley, his third of the game. 19-point lead, down to two to go. Missed shot opportunity for UC Irvine. Rebounded by Joyner, pushing it up the court. How about one more three? Here is Spratley. Will he shoot this one? He will, and it's up and good. Spratley off the bench. How about the freshman? As we pass it up one more time, 4 seconds left, and Spratley, just why not? Pulling that one up. It's an 18-point game, and that one will do it. UC Irvine goes down by 18 in the championship. And how about Long Beach State here in season one, punching their ticket to the NCAA tournament? Long Beach has come a long way. And honestly, you know, we've found an identity, and it's really just living and dying by the three. Storm, how about this game though? 30 points, 7 assists. Vontaze Bell couldn't get going in this one. He did better than our first matchup we had with them. But to be the second leading scorer in the conference, he was held in check. Baz Helcott did Helcott things. I mean, he was great defensively. He didn't score at all, but 6 rebounds. He was guarding their best player the whole game. He was magnificent. Tekashi had only two points, I should say. And then Caesar shot the ball well. He went 5 of 10 from 3, but Storm was just unstoppable. 30 points. He hit 6 threes, 7 assists, and Spratley off the bench was just great. I mean, if that production was there all year, I mean, I don't know if there's probably not a sixth man of the year, but he would have definitely got it if there was an award for that. Aiden Johnson had 9, and honestly, he did not show up in the second half at all. He was scoring pretty well in the first, but did not show up at all. Vontaze Bell only had 10, but this was just a great game defensively, and we wore them out before punching our ticket into the NCAA tournament. So now we move on to the tournament to see our seeding. And it looks like Tennessee has number one seed in the West with a 26-6 record. Alabama has a number one seed, 28-3 record. And we are not in this region as well, so I'm guessing we'll be in one of the next two, obviously. In the East, Illinois, 28-4. They are the number one seed. And I'm just looking down this list. No Long Beach State in the East region. And Cal in the South region is number one, 28-3. But I do not see Long Beach State at all. I'm not sure what's going on. But then I think about it. TBD for Cal. That means that we are playing in the play-in game versus Montana State. So we don't even get a 16 seed. We had to play in the play-in game here. So we play Montana State, who was very, very good in their conference. I mean, they were extremely good. Morris Pierce is their best player, and I think that he is a great point guard for them. But we have our hands full. This team went 15-1 in their conference, 21-10 overall. They are very, very good. And honestly, they just blew the doors off of their conference. I mean, they went 15-1 in the regular season and then just swept the conference tournament, punching their ticket in for the play-in game. But here we face a pretty good lineup here. Justin Veal at center is very, very good. And honestly, looking at Morris Pierce and Justin Veal, those are two of the top, you know, mid-major point guard center combos. And you can just see here, I mean, everybody on their team can score. So I had to switch up the lineup a little bit here. I decided to give Delmatrice Bamaye the start in this game. So here we are. This is the official NCAA tournament, but I don't really consider the playing game the NCAA tournament. Here's a shot right away. Joyner gets us going in this one. And he knocks it through. It's an early 3-0 lead here for Long Beach. Here's some good defense, but picked up in that time. It's a jump shot. And Brian Gibson, the senior, hits that one. So here we are working it inside to Hellcott. He lays it in. A little bit of contact on that one. It's an early 5-2 lead. Nice shot by Hellcott inside. So now here in the post, Storm trying to play some defense. But Pierce, like I highlighted before, he's really, really good. He's a dynamic point guard. He gets in for the easy two. So let's see what we can do running a little motion offense. Here's a three, and that is knocked down by Wendell Caesar. And he hits his first three of the game. It's an 8-4 lead early on for Long Beach. So we're getting it around this time. Montana State answering with the elbow jumper. That's what they do. They score well. Everybody touches the ball in their offense. It's just a two-point game back and forth so far here in the first half. So here, Joyner back to the outside, and that's a three. He hits his second three of the game. He's 2-for-3 from the field. It's an 11-8 game here early on. So here is Caesar once again working around to Joyner. Another three, and it's good. Hand in his face and everything. This team is just on fire shooting the three the last about three games. So rebound this time. Delmatrice Bomaye already making a mark here in his first game starting, but Caesar runs to the three and pulls up and knocks it down. And he does extend this lead here. 7 points here in the first half. So 11 minutes to go now. Here is Storm handling the ball, passing it outside to J.D. Joyner, but back to Storm open for the three, and it's knocked down. 86% to start this game here, and now we have the early 8-point lead. Block shot that time by Hellcott, playing good defense as always. Joyner pushes it up the court to the corner. Storm, a little jab step, but he can't create any separation. But now using a pick and roll, wide open Joyner, it's good. They collapse on Storm. They've been watching the film. You know Storm is just a threat to get inside the lane and have an easy two. But here is Joyner hitting threes. Another corner one. And that's knocked in. Joyner, 15 points, 5-of-6 from three here in the first half. And wow, what a start to this game for this LBSU offense. So here is Caesar at the top getting the pass away from Storm. Look at him, just sitting wide open. Why not? It's good. 11-point lead here for the Long Beach State 49ers. And look at the defense that time. That was an easy miss layup. We have numbers. It's 5-on-4. Wendell Caesar just looking for an open man. Storm shoots. It's good. Another bucket. Are you surprised at all if we make it? I mean, at this point, I'm worried if we miss these shots because we are that hot. And now it is a 12-point lead. And we're just getting rebounds, playing good defense, and just running the offense. Here is Storm. Another pick. And it's good from three. That is like a Steph Curry pull-up. I mean, he just gets a sliver of space. He's hitting that shot. Now working it inside. Look at this, Tekashi. We are just playing with these boys at this point. It gets up to a 15-point lead here in the first half. But now with 9 seconds left, here's a step back three, I should say. Storm misses it, but an 11-point lead going into halftime as they heave it up. And, man, we are just smoking from three. It is just insane what we are doing up to this point. And now we move on to the second half. Here is a fadeaway jump shot, rebound, and Montana State misses that one. We have numbers once again here, 5-on-4 while the guy is on the ground. And look at this, working it around. Joyner stops, shoots. It's good. I mean, it's a 12-point lead. Joyner hits his 6-3 of the game, and this is just crazy how hot we are from the field. Rebound this time, push it up the court. Joyner, I mean, you gotta stop the ball. It's good. I mean, this is just incredible. They are leaving us open for three, especially in transition. That is our strength. They need to watch the film, pass it up. Joyner, once again, open, and it's good. I mean, it's just every single shot is right on. And Joyner is just hot this game. He's going to break the three-point record here for Long Beach as we now pass it up. Another rebound in transition. Joyner.
Bang! That one goes down!
It's just insane. 11-point lead here for Long Beach. Joyner hits it. I believe that's his eighth or ninth three here in this game, and we just cannot miss. Now a 9-point lead. And look at Montana State, though, crawling back, transition dunk after the steal. And now it's just a 7-point game. We do call a timeout there to slow momentum, but they do get back into this game. Jump shot. It's back to a 5-point lead. A minute and a half left. Here is Storm handling the ball, pick and roll, stepping back out, just wasting some time here. We need to run this clock just a little bit. Tekashi comes for the pick. Storm drives a lane, open layup, and it's good. We needed something to break that momentum there. It's back to a 7-point lead. Now another pick and roll this time. Tekashi inside, wide open Storm. In the corner, it's good. That one should seal this game up, and it does. We do win the play-in game, and we will face the number one seed in our region in the Cal Bears, who finished with the number 4 overall RPI ranking. And now we get to face a number 1 seed as a 16. But what a game shooting in this one by Joyner. I mean, could he miss? It was Zion Storm last game. He had 30 points, but this time Joyner just went off and he could not miss in transition. I mean, it was just incredible. 11-point lead, 63-52, ended up being the final. And quite honestly, I mean, our shooting has won us these games. I mean, there's no other reason. It's not even our defense is good, but our shooting is just keeping us in these games. And I hope it carries over into this Cal game, because we know this is probably going to be a very tough game, because, you know, we've been playing against teams that are similar ratings to us, like, you know, high 50s, low 60s overall, sometimes 70. But now we're playing a team in Cal that has like literally all 80 overall guys. I mean, these are like the top of the top. And in these old games, you know, you don't have a ton of 90 overall guys. If you do, they're amazing. But this Cal team is like, their whole just squad is full of 80 overalls. This is going to be a very, very tough game. And in this game, we shot 57% from three as a team. I mean, if you shoot that well from three, you better win at this point, because, man, our offense definitely showed up for that game. So now we play Cal. 1 seed, 16 seed. They were 28-3 overall, 16-2 in their conference. They also have the conference player of the year as well. This is going to be fun. Hit subscribe. Hit that like button. Stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go. I've been working hard for a minute. The ones who don't deserve it seem to be the ones that get it. The ones who speak the truth never get the recognition, but the ones that act foolish seem to get all the attention. It don't matter though, yeah. And it don't even matter though, nope. Hey, it don't even matter.